Hey guys, so today I just got this package in the mail, and this is the Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer from IT Cosmetics. They released 48 shades, well they had, you know, a couple before, but they revamped it and came out with new shades. And they decided to send me the middle shade, so it's the second arm right there. I have all of those shades right now. I wanted to figure out for myself and for my foundation twinsies, just generally give you guys some swatches and references of these shades. A concealer and maybe a powder foundation, and do like a separate video for that powder foundation that I'm gonna try out. I'm considering trying out these J.Cat powder foundations that are supposed to be like aquasurance, so really nice like formula. I don't know, I got a few requests. So I am heading to Sephora later to make a few returns and just check out anything I need to check out. I rarely go to Sephora, but when I do, I usually look a mess. So today I was like, you know what? I have like a little lunch date with a friend. I'm going to get myself together, because you know people look at you differently when you're wearing makeup and you're not wearing makeup at Sephora. It's just a true statement. I have shade 20 through shade 25.5 to show you guys. Heads up, I did these swatches after I did my face application, so I didn't know about these shades yet. This is what the packaging looks like, and it has the claims, which is full coverage, anti-aging, and waterproof. And then the shade number and name is at the top. Funny enough, I didn't really like this concealer the first time I... Why? Here is the new tube. It used to be skinnier and longer, but now we have like a shorter, wider situation, and the shade is on the back. Oddly enough, I wasn't ever really a huge fan of this concealer. I liked a lot of other products and like brushes from IT Cosmetics, but this under eye concealer, though it's like a super bestseller, cult favorite within the brand, I couldn't make it work for me. I'm not sure if maybe my taste has changed now. We're gonna find out together. But this is more of a hydrated finish. Very, very creamy. And I do like hydration, but it was very thick as well. A little bit goes a long way. And I, you know, didn't like the shades they came in before because the medium was really salmon-y and it just didn't go with what I wanted at that time. So I haven't really used it a lot in the years, but I'm hoping this changes my mind. Just by looking at the chart, I know my under eye color is not probably gonna be one of these because I would probably lean at like the end of the light shades. So I'm probably in the first three shades of the selection that I have. So that would be 20, 20.5, and 21. And they actually say what tones are on the shade. So it says medium N for neutral. We got medium San W for warm. And then the next shade after that is medium tan, which is also warm. So I'm probably gonna have to use the lightest underneath my eye and see if that's even gonna, you know, give us something today. But between the two shades, I want to say medium sand or tan will be the correct tone for my face. I'm really nervous. I shouldn't put this on my face. I should probably down here. Oh, it's a lot lighter than I thought it was gonna be. So maybe we will have some sort of under eye shade. A little lighter than expected. This is 20.5 medium sand. I think it's gonna start warming up in a second, but we're gonna keep going. This isn't too bad. This is number 22, medium golden. It's the first shade that's shown an actual like warm yellow to me. Everything else, like this is not bad. This is also a warm tone. This is 21, medium tan. And it is a lot different than 20.5 and 20. Medium golden looks like the best match for my face. 20.5 for underneath my eyes. Each concealer retails for $26 and you get 12 milliliters, a little less than half an ounce for product, but a little bit does go a long way. And I am using the Airbrush Flawless Complexion Brush number 132. This has a all over buffer side and a precision side. So I'm just gonna tap this on my under eye. For a medium shade, it definitely looks bright. So I'm like eating crow right now. IT Cosmetics knew what they were doing as far as sending me the whole medium arm. Holy moly, this is very brightening. I do not think this looks like the shade on the card. This is definitely brighter in person. I have like these deep tear drop little canal things that I can't stand. But this concealer is supposed to erase anything, so. Still has such an interesting look to it. Like, it looks really smooth on camera, but very, very close. I'm gonna see if you guys can see it. Like, it definitely has, like, some texture to it, which is what turned me off of the concealer when I was younger and I first tried it. don't mind too much now. I think with loose powder, back in the day, like, I didn't use loose powder for my under eyes. That might fix it. I'm gonna try out the new Laura Mercier translucent powder, but this is the glow formula. Really? That's all that came out? This is more like it. Oh, that just made the problem so much worse. Now I have a lot of texture. Okay, switching powders. Too Faced Peach Perfect. I love the lid. That looks way better than this situation we got going on right now. I'm trying to buff it away so I can reset it. Or maybe I can water it down of some sort. But yeah, the glow powder, probably not great combo. The more you know. So now, let's work on these scars. Number 22 is definitely a good match for my skin. Ignore my forehead. My forehead has no product on it. My forehead is always darker than the rest of my body. But this looks about right. See how this shade is the only warm one that shows really warm out of all the other ones? This is the 22. I have such redness like on my chin, around my nose, and obviously any fresh extractions that I have that are like, you know, red or swollen or whatever the heck like that, that I don't do this a lot, like just concealer and then powder on top, because I could just do foundation and like tinted moisture or something like that and then have an all over coverage, because I feel like it just, you know, it's not as much spot concealing for me when I got every little corner below my eyes. That's probably just me. It's a personal problem, skin condition right now. I'm gonna grab one of the three shades I have and try to go over it. The texture right now though is not, it's not great. You can kind of just see that it's sitting on top of my skin compared to melted onto my skin, which bothers me a little. Ew. This powder has a beautiful finish. I'm not mad at the shade. I think this is my closest shade because I wouldn't want to go any darker. And it is lighter than my forehead, luckily. So, looks like a pretty good match. I'd probably put something lighter just underneath my eyes. Or just leave it as bright as it is and try not to bring this up too far. But I really like the powder. Okay, this just became like a dual review. So this retails for $14. Blends beautifully like a freaking dream. So it comes in 8 different shades and I have the 4th one on. So it has cactus flower extract, which is an antioxidant. It's supposed to keep your skin moisturized. Chamomile to help with any inflammation you have going on, calm your skin. And chlorella, which I haven't heard of, but this is supposed to help with the skin's collagen production. Powder is crazy because it says it locks in moisture and like has a whole different finish while still controlling your oils and gives you like a medium to full coverage, which it does, because I basically look like I'm wearing a foundation right now. I'm gonna finish up my makeup and talk to you guys in just a second. I just finished my makeup and I thought I was going like light, not doing too much today. And then one of my friend's makeup palettes came in. This is the Raven Elise palette by Deca Scarlett. And I really like how my makeup came out. Do you guys like? If you guys want to see what I use to do this look, it'll be on my Instagram. You can follow that. It'll be a little video there with everything listed. Back to the topic at hand. I think for someone who's not wearing foundation, who's only wearing technically powder foundation, so I am wearing foundation, powder and concealer, this looks like a full face beat. I am happy with the colors I picked. Is this like my new Holy Grail concealer? Absolutely not. But I am happy with the new updated shades, because the prior shades, like just having medium, which don't even get me started on how crazy that looked on me, this is a lot better. And hopefully you guys enjoyed seeing what shade matched me, and hopefully the swatches were helpful for you guys too. We ended up doing this little 2-in-1 review basically on the JCAT Aquassurance powder foundation, which I really, really like. I'm not gonna do a full-on wear test of this because it's already so late in the day, but I will let you guys know what I think about this in an upcoming favorites video, so just stay tuned with that. Powder foundation, you kinda gotta see what you're gonna combine with it, because it goes on top of things, or you know, just runs solo. I'll see how it does. It's already raining today and really late, but since I used it, I figured I would just touch base on it. So that's it for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. I hope you don't mind. I'm just like playing around with makeup. That doesn't have to be a specific like only this and only that and where were you going with your makeup look that day. I'm still just, you know, enjoying my makeup, playing around with it and seeing where it takes me every day, and I figured why not just turn on the camera. But yes, if you guys enjoyed, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't yet, and I will see you guys in a later video.